and woman mess ups in mind.
Thank you,
he
Jesus.
He knew they was going to mess up.
Yes, Lord.
So,
sure did.
You know, that's part of our salvation. How do we know that? Because throughout the scriptures, we read about people mess ups.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
and we
Lord.
Like, God, now, how, you know, they
yes,
don't walk
Lord.
And they doing all this, these bad things. So you have to believe in your heart. When God brought salvation, he had your mess ups in mind.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
but
Jesus.
What he did was made a way. You yourself, personally, cannot destroy your salvation. In other words, you yourself, personally, can't mess up so bad that it destroys your salvation.
Yes,
it destroys what Jesus has done on the cross. Your mess ups were in mind when he brought salvation. When he brought salvation through Christ, he made it in such a, how can I explain, in such a peculiar way.
Yes, Lord.
That all your mess up won't destroy what Jesus did on the cross.
Hallelujah.
He made it with the utmost security.
Thank you.
He made it in such a way that even you cannot destroy it. That's good. That's good to know. That
yes,
all
Lord.
My mess ups will not destroy my salvation.
In the name of Jesus.
He had it in mind
yes,
when
Lord.
He made man. Let's go to some scriptures. Even before the law came concerning Abraham, you know, Abraham had some mess ups. But
yes,
was he going to destroy his promise to Abraham? No. It wasn't going to destroy. Let's go to Genesis 20. He had Abraham mess ups in mind when he promised to give Abraham a seed. And he was going to let Abraham's seed get to his promised land. Go to Genesis. You know, you can never read in the Bible where God reprimanded Abraham on nothing. Rebuked Abraham. You don't see no evidence in Abraham's life where God rebuked him.
Yes,
even though Abraham lied, right? And that's interesting. Because look, Abraham is called the father of faith.
Yes, Lord.
But there's no instance where God literally rebuked Abraham for his wrong.
Yes, Lord.
He did just the opposite. He rebuked those that Abraham was coming to for his Amalek. Go to chapter 20. Now, you would think that he would rebuke Abraham for lying to King Abimelech, but he rebuked Abimelech and not
chapter
Abraham.
20 of Genesis.
Chapter 20 of Genesis. He didn't rebuke Abraham for lying to King Abimelech. He rebuked King Abimelech. Everybody got chapter 20? And this is Abraham, when he lied and said Sarah was his sister, but he didn't tell Abimelech that Sarah was also his wife. So, right? And you see nowhere in the text where God reprimanded Abraham for lying. That's interesting. Everybody got Genesis 20? Let's start at verse 2. Genesis 20, verse 2. And Abraham said of Sarah, his wife, she is my sister. And Abimelech, king of Gerar, sent and took Sarah. But God came to Abimelech in a dream by night and said to him, behold, thou art but a dead man. For the woman which thou hast taken, for she is a man's wife. But Abimelech had not come near her. And he said, Lord,
yes, Lord.
Would thou slay also of righteous nations? Listen to what this king says to God. He said, said he not unto me, she is my sister. Abraham did tell him that. Abraham never told Abimelech that she was his, that Sarah was his wife. So he was actually lying, right? But God rebuked Abimelech. And Abimelech said, hold up, will you slay a righteous nation? Said he not unto me, she is my sister. And she, even Sarah said the same thing. Even she herself said, he is my brother.
Mm-hmm. Indeed, which he was.
And which he was. But they were married also. He said, in the integrity of my heart and innocency of my hands have I done this. This is Abimelech talking to God, the king. And God said unto him in a dream, yea, I know that thou didst this in the integrity of thy heart. For I also withheld thee from sinning. You know, so God can withhold a person from sinning if you want to. Because
yes,
he held Abimelech from sinning against Abraham, against God himself, against me. Therefore suffered I thee not to touch her. Now therefore restore the man his wife, for he is a prophet, and he shall pray for